the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear sisters and brothers, every time we stand at this altar, the one voice we need to hear is Matthew 11:28. Come to me, Jesus said. Come to me. An invitation. Invitation to everyone tired, everyone burdened. And that's what we are. Burdened and tired with the many problems in our life, with the powers of sin haunting us all the time, with all the aches and ailments of our body, with all the strain of family relationships. We are burdened, and therefore we are invited into the presence of Jesus with the promise, I will give you rest. The rest Jesus gave to everyone brokenhearted. The sick found healing in him. The sinners found forgiveness in him. The sad found comfort in him. And that's what we are, sick and sad and sinful. Let us find comfort in Jesus. And that's the promise Jesus gives us. He will give us rest. Let's keep our hands open in front of us. Let us confess together. Let us tell Jesus how much we need him. Life is so hard on us. We need him to give us rest that we may move forward according to his will. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Hearts are longing for your merciful intervention. We are burdened, we are tired, standing before you, offering the burden of our life in your hands on this altar. Accept us. Let us find comfort in your presence. We make this prayer through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. Please be seated.
First reading, a reading from the first letter of St. Peter, chapter 4, verses 12 to 19. Beloved, do not be surprised that a trial by fire is occurring among you, as if something strange were happening to you. But rejoice to the extent that you share in the sufferings of Christ, so that when His glory is revealed, you may also rejoice exultantly. If you are insulted for the name of Christ, blessed are you, for the Spirit of glory and of God rests upon you. But let no one among you be made to suffer as a murderer, a thief, an evildoer, or as an intriguer. But whoever is made to suffer as a Christian should not be ashamed, but glorify God because of the name. For it is time for the judgment to begin with the household of God. If it begins with us, how will it end for those who fail to obey the gospel of God? And if the righteous one is barely saved, where will the godless and the sinner appear? As a result, those who suffer in accord with God's will hand their souls over to a faithful Creator as they do good. The word of the Lord.
Look to Him and be radiant. Your faces shall never be ashamed. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy the man who takes refuge in Him. Look to Him and be radiant. Your faces shall never be ashamed. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy the man who takes refuge in Him. I sought the Lord and He answered me. He delivered me from all my fear. This poor man cried and the Lord heard him, saved him from all his trouble. Look to Him and be radiant. Your faces shall never be ashamed. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy the man who takes refuge in Him. Oh, feel the Lord among you the saints. Oh, those who fear Him have no woe. The eyes of the Lord are towards the right, and His ears towards their cry. Look to Him and be radiant. Your faces shall never be ashamed. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy the man who takes refuge in Him. Happy the
We shall rise for the acclamation.
Praise and honor to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Praise and honor to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
He that is in you is greater than he that is in the world.
Praise and honor to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Praise and honor to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 11, verses 25 to 30. At that time, Jesus said in reply, I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. For although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father. And no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart. And you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord. Let us offer on this altar all the pain, everything that you call unfortunate. Let's bring it all to Jesus and raise it all up. Salvation flows down to you and to your family. Let us sing together this offering here.
Bless this gift so long. Make it righteous in thy sight. Bless these gifts, O Lord. Bless these gifts so long. Make it righteous in thy sight. Bless these gifts, O Lord. We offer you our hearts. We offer you our minds. We offer you ourselves, O Lord, as a token of our love. We offer you this bread, work of human hands. And love, we break this bread, O Lord, which is your body now. We offer you this wine, work of human hands. Now it is your blood, O Lord, the blood you shed for us. Bless this gift, O Lord. Make it righteous in thy sight. Bless this gift, O Lord.
Pray, brethren, that our sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, for the praise and glory of your name, for our salvation and salvation of our families. We offer to you all our pain in our body and in our mind. We offer it all to you, claiming your promise you would comfort us with your heavenly comfort flowing into our hearts. Let's be able to bear this cross and come after you on the way to Calvary, from there to the glory of the resurrection. We make this prayer through the same Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received a heart to confess the infinite power of your majesty. Since by the wondrous power of the cross, your judgment on the world is now revealed, and the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we do give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are filled with your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess Until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of His death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, George, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
My dear sisters and brothers, today we have great confidence. Whatever happens to us, whatever goes wrong with us, however sick we fall, we will be able to say with St. Paul, if God is with us, who can be against us? With that confidence of the children, let's all raise our hands up to our God and pray in the words our Savior taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace and love.
Offer for us, you take away the sins of the world. Oh, grant us peace, grant us lasting peace. Lamb of God.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
soul standeth for the final prayer. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for revealing the mystery of the cross, the mystery of our pain, the mystery behind the unfortunate events of our life. In such tough moments, let's be able to come to you, O God, and find our rest in your presence. Find our healing and forgiveness in your compassion. We make this prayer through the same Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let's go in the peace and joy of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.